Hi everyone, welcome to another video from voiceaiwrapper. So today we're gonna explain how we integrate with retail. In short, voiceaiwrapper already integrates with VAPI voice APIs. Now we build an integration for retail, and you can connect your retail API keys, white label the voiceair offering plus markup minutes, and I'm gonna show you how to do that. So let's dive in. All right, so I'm inside the voiceaiwrapper account. And on the left-hand side, you have your account settings. I'll go through these in details. And then when you add a voice provider, currently we have integrations for VAPI and retail, and we will release other integrations, including one for 11 Labs Conversational AI, Ultravox, and a couple of other providers very soon. So after you connect your voice API providers, and you can add multiple API providers to the same account, you'll see something like this. I have one for VAPI right now, but we're going to talk about retail white labeling today. So we'll focus on retail. So once I add my retail keys, I just need to add my retail organization name and the retail API key. And that syncs my retail account with voiceaiwrapper. So I can head over to the dashboard. And now you get to see the admin side of the dashboard, wherein you will find all the agents which you have created inside retail listed. You will have all your phone numbers listed, and whatever components you've created inside retail, they will be available here, right? There's also an option to create inbound and outbound campaigns using a voiceaiwrapper. We'll have a very detailed video on this, but in short, the advantage of using outbound campaigns with voiceaiwrapper is you can automatically add leads via API. So you can add leads, and you can also dynamically update and remove leads from a campaign real time. This also has the option to connect with a server URL. You can basically, if you're using GHL, for instance, you can create a inbound webhook in GHL, and you can paste the webhook URL here, and that will send all your call logs, transcripts, and recording to, let's say, your GHL CRM, right? So leads is where you can either feed leads into a campaign using API, or you can upload a CSV, or you can add leads manually. Under settings, you can pick the agent that you wanna call from. You can select the phone number, the time zone you wanna start the calls, the days of the week that you wanna call, the total number of attempts, dial attempts per lead, the maximum number of dial attempts you're gonna make to every lead, and the time gap between each dial attempt, right? Plus, you have a setting here which allows you to decide what you consider an answered call. Yeah, so if you want to mark voicemails as answered, you toggle this on or you toggle this off. All your call logs from your campaign, irrespective of whether it's an inbound or outbound campaign, are going to show up here. So you'll be able to see the call logs, the recording, transcripts, and all of that. And this is also downloadable in a CSV format. Plus, you also get detailed campaign analytics, and you also get cost metrics, and you have an option to decide whether you want to show the cost metrics or not to your client. What shows on the admin side is the admin cost, which means your cost to your voice API provider plus the markup, whereas on the client side, the client only gets to see whatever markup voice minute cost you're billing them. So I'll head back to account settings. So now to white label this platform and use your retail account to offer white label voice AI services, you first of all need to connect your subdomain, and then you can add assets, your logo, your brand name. And once these DNS records are added to your subdomain, when the client logs into your subdomain, they would see your brand, your name, your URL without any mention of retail or voice AI wrapper anywhere. You can create unlimited clients and client orgs. So I've just created a client org here. As you can see, the first option is to add users. So this is where you create users. These are the credentials that your client is going to use to log into your white label version of the platform. Then you have something called asset groups. So asset groups is where you define what campaigns, which assistant, what all you are associating with that white label account. If you leave this blank, the client is not going to see anything when they log in. Then you have granular controls on what level of access you want to give to clients, whether you want them to view phone numbers and all of that. So this way you set up your client orgs. And then to bill your clients, the first step that you would do is you connect your Stripe account. As soon as you connect your Stripe keys, now this allows you to bill your clients directly and get payments directly into your Stripe account. So once I've created a client org here, if I go over to billing, you know, you see that for this client, I've created this product, right? This particular plan. Now you can create multiple products under agency products. If I click on add products, there are several options to bill clients. So you can bill clients based on usage only, and you can mark up that cost on top of what your voice API provider is charging you. Or you can charge someone a subscription fee plus overage. So I can say, you know, the client pays me $100 and gets 100 minutes per month. Anything beyond that is charged at 20 cents per minute, so on and so forth. Right? Or you can also have, you also get an option to charge a subscription and then give the client an option to buy usage packs. So usage packs are very useful, handy when your client has like varying usage periods, and you want to give them the option to buy minute packages, right? So it's very straightforward. You just define the number of minutes and the price for those minutes, and the client can go in and purchase them from your white label account anytime. We also have another unique feature called SaaS Creator. SaaS Creator basically allows you to create different plans inside Voice AI Wrapper, and then once your plans have been created, you can then create a test pricing table, something like this, and you can take this code and put it on your website, and people can come in, and all of this is configurable. And when visitors come to your website, they click get started, or you know, start trial or start now, we can rename all of this. It automates the entire client onboarding process. So instead of creating a client org and giving them access, so if you want to onboard clients on autopilot in a SaaS mode, you can just create a SaaS Creator pricing table, embed it on your site, and you can onboard clients automatically in SaaS mode. So that's it for now. We also have a option to chat with our support team here. Plus, there are resources available, and you can set up a call using the help section. We are happy to take feedback, and we are constantly releasing new features. So if you subscribe to this channel, and if you have any features requests in mind, we'll be happy to accommodate them. Thank you for watching, and hope to see you on the platform soon.